Who has entered my lovely cavernous realm? No response. Truly interesting. Well, it is of no consequence. I can find you regardless of where you hide. So, I do implore you to simply submit yourself to my presence. Ah, I see. So, it shall have to be a search. Well, luckily for me, my sense of smell is superb, even for my own species. I should be able to find you in no time. You know, the scent of a human is very distinct from that of a rock, especially this one. I get you now. So, shall you explain yourself, or should I cut your little meeting short? So, you just stumbled into the cave? But what were you seeking? Treasure? Adventure? Perhaps ancient ruins? Yes, yes. Regardless, though, you will not find what you are searching for. Spelunkers like you are but a bane to my kind, a real nuisance to our ecosystem. So, I'd best suggest you leave. What? You sprained your leg? How curious. Perhaps you do not leave immediately. Let me take you in for a short bit. Why? I suppose you would not know this. However, I am a stupendous surgeon. Down in these realms, many monsters can come to me for my medical services. My knowledge of the human anatomy is a bit rusty, so do keep that in mind. It is not often that I deal with human feet. Often it is a tail or the feet of some mammalian creature. You know, your structure is quite special. Well, since you are injured, I must find the best way to help you recover. I may be bitter to you humans who dare enter these lands, but I am never bitter to a patient. If I bring you to the surface now, it would be suicide for you to survive and murder on my hands. So, let me carry you to my house. But first, tell me where your pain is felt, so I can properly apply pressure to that area. Ah, I see. Your left ankle. Interesting. Please, just simply rest up while I search for the source of your problem. Ah, yes. A quick examination should do. Oh, that seems to be twisted, but I'm not quite sure. Let me check some more. Oh, yes, that's definitely something to note. Oh no, that is really bad. No. That is certainly more than a twist. Oh. Yes. That broken. That's certainly a fracture. Yes. As you heard, your ankle is broken. Note that this is just based upon my observations, so I'm unable to tell how severe the fracture is. I think it would be best if I set you up with a cast right now. Yes, this won't take too long. I have the materials just underneath this bed you are sitting on. Oh, how long will it take to recover? How old are you? I am just kidding. I can tell that you're at a relatively young age for humans. So, I would estimate at least a month or two. Probably more if you get too risky. But in all hopes, a month or two. If that is not the case, then I have to check if the cast I used doesn't fit the needs of your ankle. Yeah, I know that sounds bad, but in all honesty, that is not likely to be the case. Let me just get this on. Okay, first we straighten the lifting leg. And then to place this here to allow for a straightening of the bone. Yes. Oh, good. Now we take this and wrap it around to keep this stable and tight. Now let me just wrap it some more. A little more. And there. That should be good for you. If there are any changes needed, just tell me later. As for now, just rest here. Oh, where will you stay? Here, of course. I assume that is all right with you. We do have a hospital here, it's just I can't remember the policy on humans. If I remember correctly, they aren't allowed, but I might be wrong. I mean, I told you earlier, we do not particularly like humans, especially not ones that come down here. I mean, this is supposed to be our refuge from the upper world humans. I point to what you have done to the upper worldly creatures, vampires, lycanthropes, and other sorts. You hunt them, and then you call them monsters. It is a little disgraceful, I believe. However, I believe the fraction does not sum up the whole. Regardless, it would be in your best interest to stay here. There are some who differ in my sympathies. Yes, thank you for understanding. However, I do have one question. You never really answered this earlier, but for what reason did you come down here for? Yes, I know you said spelunking, but I would just like some clarification of the details. Oh, so you are in search of a great cavern? Why, I have never really heard of that place. Perhaps I can help you find it once you recover. Would you give a synopsis of its beauties? Or perhaps lack thereof? Oh, interesting. A cavern with blue crystalline water. Anything else I should know? So there is a waterfall careening into that lake that is formed. Quite interesting. How did you hear of this place? Oh, so it was a story your grandfather told you. Well, in that case, unless there is some sort of map that I can gaze my eyes upon, I am forced to believe that it is nothing but a mere folk tale. Oh, there is a map. Well, where is it? In your backpack? Oh, well then, let me go get it so I can see. Ah, this map looks quite interesting. It seems to be leading just to the eastward of our great city. Perhaps I can scout out a successful path for you to travel, seeing as you slipped up and broke your ankles attempting to go there in the first place. I should make sure that there is nothing that should make you have to return to my home for sanctuary. Oh, well, of course. I won't engage with the cavern itself. I would rather just mark out a course through the long hall. If this map is to be believed, there are no caverns on the approach of the Grand One. So it should be said that I would be safe to continue. Yet, even if I see it, I shall not make my approach any further. That would be a violation of your trust. I surely could not sustain such an act. Yes, yes. Then that must be what I shall do. Nevertheless, we shall not go until you have your full capabilities. I would hardly support the idea of perpetuating such serious soreness upon your ankles. Speaking of which, while you rest, what should I prepare for you to eat? It makes sense to cook you something since you need to stay. Oh, a peanut butter and jelly sandwich with some milk? Listen, I have never heard of this peanut butter or this jelly that you speak of, but I know I can make a sandwich. I mean, I recently caught a boar, so would a pork sandwich be suffice? I don't think I could get a peanut and a butter anyways. Ah, okay, a pork sandwich will do. Now, do you want me to put anything on it? I have some sauces made up from mustard seeds, as well as some sauces made from eggs. I normally put that on what I make for myself, but I don't know if you would like that. Huh? You don't know what mustard sauce or egg sauce is? I recently learned the recipes from the bottles I found at a camping ground. I believe it called mustard and mayonnaise. I also saw this ketchup, but I don't know how to manufacture it. Oh, so you have heard of them. So, what would you like on your sauce? Both mustard and egg? This is nice. It seems as if we have similar interests. Let me go make our foods. Ah, yes. That was quite a good meal. Did you appreciate yours? That is good to hear. Well, I should let you get your rest. It is best that you get a necessary amount of slumber. It helps to increase the regenerative processes of your humanly infrastructure. Or at least I assume. I don't have much knowledge on the inner workings of the human body, but I should have some idea on it. It should be similar to that of a vampire, and I have operated plenty of times on vampires. Regardless, sleep up. Huh? Oh, you want a blanket? Okay. I normally leave them under this bed. Ah, yes. Here you go. Let me tuck you up right here. Good night. Rest tight. And, well, do not let the bed bugs bite.